Go Jet.
Jet Am on the screen.
Point the eye at me.
I am, and I'm on the front.
Yeah, all the way around then. Must be the other camera.
Shall I wait till John comes and ask him?
Just a sec, let me have a look. Sorry about this, folks.
St. John. Live. The comment section. Formats. Creative tools. Flip camera. Flashlight selector. Flat. Invite. Button. Invite to go live. Tag. Button. Comment. Finish. Finish. Comment. Tag. Invite. Invite. Flashlight selector. Flip camera. Front facing. Button. Back facing.
That's got it.
Okay.
Switch off.
My fault.
Okay. Just give a shout to Charlie and we'll get going.
Yeah, that's right. He's ready.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to introduce Jack Scrimshaw, Acker, means also known as Dr. Moonshine. That's his stage name. He's going to play guitar in the first half, and then he'll play the piano in the second half. I don't know whether we're going to have requests or we're going to have sing along, what we're going to have. But whatever we get.
And you got another call.
First of all, he's going to introduce himself and tell you all the instruments that's cluttering about at home. Thank you, Jack.
Thank you, Charles. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Or should I say, ladies and gentlemen? Yes, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Doc Moonshine, better known as Jack Scrimshaw. I've got family in the audience. And as Charles said, I am a multi-instrumentalist. And when he heard that, he had great expectations. but I let him down, because I only bought the guitar. Because I heard you've got a beautiful piano, just to my left here. And in the second half, I'm going to be, attempting to play a bit of sing-along on that. But amongst the instruments I play various banjos, mandolin, several different types of guitar, double bass, the drums, and various whistles and harmonicas. And that all being totally blind since birth, my friends. And that is simply because I had nothing better to do than learn instruments. That's the excuse anyway. But no, the truth of the matter is that I love music. Music is the air I breathe and the life I live. It's wonderful. So we're going to start out here with a song. As I said, I've got family in the audience. A very distinguished member of my family. Just off to the right there is my great uncle, Bill. And Bill's travelled all over the world. Been to America, Mexico, Ireland. And because of my Irish heritage, I sing a lot of Irish music. And this is a song about the Irish immigrants who went to America, thought it was hot, and then they found out that what they got wasn't as hot as they thought it was. It's called The Boys Come Rolling Home. I always will remember well the day we went away, sailing out to Dublin in the morning. Our hopes were on tomorrow as we kissed the girls farewell, but our dreams are on the day of our returning. There'll be dancing, romancing, and never more we'll roam. There'll be rolling in the hay, there'll be whiskey in the tay, when the boys come rolling home. We safely reach the other side in New York City Fair. In spite of wind and rain and stormy weather, we all sat down and drank a glass and wished each other well. And we said we'd all go back again together. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a lovely place you've got here, absolutely beautiful room to play in. I heard somebody saying very naughtily before I went on, it's going to look even better when they finish doing it all. I don't know who said that though, but I don't agree. I think it's wonderful. I mean, when you come from playing in pubs and things like I do, and they just, you know, don't put that there. Don't put that, you won't put that there. You're only doing this long, now you're doing this. Anyway. It's enough of all that. Let's carry on. This is a song I'm hoping a lot of you will know. In fact, I'm going to put this thing on guitar here. For those of you that were wondering what this thing is, this is for somebody who didn't learn guitar in the School of Music. I learned it in my spare time, as it were. I taught myself. So this is a song I hope some of you out there will know, written by a great man called Ewan McCall. It's called Dirty Old Town. My love by the Casper's cross, green the tree by the old canal, kiss my girl by the factory wall, dirty old town. thank you very much indeed. You're a lovely audience. You like everything. You're the best audience I've ever had. So, as you know, I told you I played various instruments, but mostly I play folk music, country music, as I told you earlier. Play a lot, particularly of Irish music, as well as the country music. Is there any particular song anybody out there would like to hear? If I know it, I'll sing it, and if I don't, well, I'll learn it and do it next time if you have them. So, anyone want to hear anything in particular?
Scarlet
River. I knew there'd be one. I'm so sorry, my dear. I'll have to learn that for you next time. I'm honestly sorry. I listened to it only the other day as well. Sorry about that. Second time lucky. No? God, these guys are easy. I'm going to play here more often. Okay, well, what we'll do is a lady who would have loved it. That sounds better, doesn't it? Amazing what having a bit of a twiddle can do, you know, with a guitar. A lady who would have loved this music is one of the ladies who really helped get me into the Irish music. And that was my grandma, my mum's mum. She's sadly no longer with us. Or my nana, as we say around here. I always sing this song for her because she was called Eileen, and this is a song by a man called Percy French about a woman called Eileen who broke a hell of a lot of hearts. She was called the Pride of Petlivore. You're very, very kind indeed. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, I've sung quite a few folk songs, but those of you that can see, you know, I've got the cowboy gear here, got the boots, and mother's on the camera doing the Facebook Live with the hat. And I haven't sung one country song. Now, there's something wrong with that. So let's remedy that right now. This is a song, this is a warning to all the mothers. And I know there must be at least a few here. And it's a warning to their sons, or maybe to grandmothers as well, for their grandchildren. It's called Mamas, Don't Let Your Babies Grow Up to Be Cowboys. Cowboys ain't easy to love, they're harder. Singing. I think I've heard some smatterings of clapping and stuff like that, which is great. Keep that up. Join in. This is your show, basically. I'm just here, you know, I'm just the catalyst, but this is your show. Catalyst, not cattle truck. Who said that? It's called the Sloop Zombie. Yeah. See, sometimes you play with the band and sometimes you don't, so that's where that comes from. Sometimes there's a guy with a squeeze box up here helping me out, but he's not here tonight, so he's stuck with me. We'll do a couple more, as I say, before I go. This is a beautiful song that I encountered some years ago. This next one, in fact, no, we're not going to do that one, we haven't got time. We'll do that one on the piano. This is definitely one that you will all know, so please join in. Very old song, old chestnut. Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling from glen to glen and down the mountainside. The summer gone and all the leaves are falling. Tis you must go and I must fight. But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. Tis I'll be here in sunshine or in shadow. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy, I love you so.
I'm going to do something that we've done before. I'm going to do a little interview.
Oh.
Jack.
Yes.
When was the first time that you picked up a guitar and thought you could play it?
The first time I picked up a guitar, I was 18 years old. I just bought the bass guitar. And I was delighted with myself, and I said to my granddad, my dad's dad, "Granddad, I've just bought a bass, this is fantastic." And he said, "What do you want one of them for? All that does is go bloody boom, boom, boom." And he said, "You want to learn a guitar?" So I did. And I thought I could play it, but I couldn't.
So how did you learn to play it?
Trial and error, simply. I learned my first chord in a pub, of all places, using a 50 pence to play, 50 pence coin. Because I heard that Brian May did that, and it took several different guitars till I found the right two or three. There's never just one. I've got two that I gig with in case one breaks, but it took about... Well, I'm still learning. I mean, I've been playing for 15 years, and I think the day you stop learning, you might as well pack up and do something else.
Did you have a mentor in any way? Did he guide you, or did...
No. My dad was a musician. Yeah, my dad was a musician, and I used to love listening to him play the guitar. He tried to teach me, and it went horribly wrong.
Because playing a guitar is not always the easiest thing to get the right strings. And
it's a very difficult instrument. It's very difficult, but when I was little, I tried an even more difficult instrument, the violin, or the fiddle. And I tried that for 6 years. I had one of the best teachers going through school, a guy called Alex Hodgson. And he was a fantastic teacher, but there was just one problem. I was a useless fiddle player.
So is this your preferred instrument? Is this one you like the best? Or?
This one and my other guitar, Vivian, they're my two favorite guitars. I've got this one here because this is the real... Real good one. This is the Four Figures guitar.
Is it the Gibson?
Yeah, that's the Gibson, yeah. That's tricky. Yeah.
Piano,
yeah.
When did you get to start playing that?
Oh, no.
Two.
A year ago.
He's not had these questions put to him before. So
year ago. This was. I first attempted it when I was two at playgroup. And been all sorts of attempts over various years, loads of different keyboards. But last year, I had a friend over from America, said that I really think you should learn to play the piano, that'd be awful nice. And I said, "Well, I don't know." And she said, "Well, you ain't gonna get much choice." And she picked one out for me, and true confession time under an interview. She actually bought me to the music shop, sat me down in front of the piano, and she said, "Right, you're buying this one." And I said, "Well, I haven't got enough shit, I'll help you." So there it is.
Very good. The reason I'm...
Never played one like this one before, though. This is beautiful.
We're going to hear this fantastic instrument in a few minutes.
Yeah.
The reason I'm asking is because I'm a musician and play a brass instrument.
Yeah.
And for a guitar player, it's... You've got, and for a violin or any instrument you play, someone's got to show you where things are. And if you've got your impediment, it's a lot more difficult, obviously, because you can't see what's happening.
Well, not only need time and commitment.
That's right. But we're so thankful that you are here, and you're going to do us another couple of songs, are you, before the break?
Absolutely, yeah, before the break. Okay. And before you sign off, Charles, as it were, I want to thank you and all the rest of the people here at Lark Hill for having me, and Mum and John who do the driving and the carrying of gear. Yeah, couldn't do it without them.
Thank you very much.
My first interview. See, now I'm cool. Now I'm in jazz mood. I've been interviewed, I'm a celebrity. I'm a little old wine drinker. I'm not Constance.
I'm sitting in a honky tonk. thought I'd get a job and just forget her.
Yes!
But in Chicago, a broken heart is still the same. Who needs a music stand? Now there's a man behind the bar for that jukebox. And that music takes me back to Tennessee. And it has put a fool in the moaner crying. I say, a little old wine drink of me.
This is going to be the last song before the little interval here, and we change instruments and have a little drop of tea.
Yeah.
In the meantime, during that interval, if anyone wants to come over, say a quick hello and anything like that, that's wonderful, because audience feedback means a hell of a lot to me. I remember one of the first gigs I played with the band, and a lovely lady, I was singing a lot of Irish music, she came over and said, "I sure the music was wonderful, it took me right back home." I said, "Well, that's wonderful." And she said, "Well, the music, no, it reminded me of the sea so much around Galway and things." I said, "Why, was it romantic?" She said, "No, it made me sick."
Last Saturday night, I got married. Me and my wife settled down. Now me and my wife.
What did you think of Jack's playing?
Oh, great.
Good.
Are at 10 to 4. Thank you very much.
Oh, you want it? Lots of messages on screen.
Yeah.
Sweet job. Comment. Missing the goals is one. Missing the goals. Dave Jones is what? Casino calls. Hi, Jack. Smiley, can you play fat? Dave, Karen, Pivot, Corner, Creative, Flipper, Flashlight Selector, Flat, Invite, Invite to go live.
I do, yeah. 1 second, guys.
I don't think that song will be suitable for this venue, and just so you know, in the next video, I can't see your messages until the end. Sorry about that, but I'll play it next time.